Hi guys, CodeTutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande.
We will start with a new topic called Fragments. To understand fragments, we have to go a bit into a history. If you just do a Google search on the API of the fragment, you will realize that it has been added in the API level 11. We are in right now 2017, and it was a way back in February of 2011 that API 11 was introduced. If you are wondering what is API 11, it is Honeycomb. And there is a reason for that. Exactly 1 year before, in April of 2010, iOS had come up with a version 3.0. And this was also the year that iPad was introduced. And to compete with iPad, Android introduced Honeycomb version, and the very first device that had Honeycomb was Motorola Xoom. So with the introduction of tablets into the handheld devices market, suddenly things had changed. The screen real estates had increased. And also, the larger screen real estate meant that they had to be leveraged in a much more different way than a normal mobile screen would be leveraged. Then Honeycomb was specifically meant for the tablets. This had also another effect that there was a lot of fragmentation in the Android OS, but it was later fixed by making sure that the next version of Android was common for both tablets and mobile phones. So with the introduction of Honeycomb and the larger screens for the handheld devices, there were more options in terms of the UI navigation that you could implement in the apps. It was like more modular approach in the screen design could be brought in. So technically speaking, what do I mean by that is, when you launch a activity and you want to navigate to a next screen, you launch another activity. And when you do this, you basically have one activity that is always visible, and it is one activity that occupies the whole screen. And with the introduction of tablet, it was now possible that there could be two modular screens that could be accommodated in the same screen, which could interact with one another. And these two modular screens that we are talking about are nothing but fragments. So you could accommodate multiple fragments in a single screen. And don't think that fragments were specifically meant for the tablets. It was meant to be used in both phones and tablets. The screen is nothing but an activity. So it is the activity which will be accommodating the fragments. And when you think about this particular statement, it will definitely lead to a lot of questions like, how are fragments accommodated in an activity? What kind of relationship does fragment have with the activity? How fragments communicate with one another? How fragments communicate with the activity itself? Do fragments have stacks just like activities? And if yes, then who manages them and how are they managed? Is it developer's responsibility to manage fragments stack? And how to manage fragments in the portrait and landscape mode? And more importantly, how to make it backward compatible? So these are some of the very common questions that anybody who would get started with fragments would have in his or her mind. So in this Android fragment series, we will explore these questions and many more in a very detailed manner. So stay tuned.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.